Jackson's representing Kids Clean Air Force. Right, Jackson? We're going to go speak to Senator Dean Heller right now, and we're going to tell him no more cuts to the EPA and do not vote for Michael Dorsey, right? We want to keep Nevada kids healthy and strong. You ready, Jackson? Let's do this.
Carson City citizen yesterday that there was there's a big manufacturing site right outside of Carson, a corporation that we know in the 80s that there was huge amounts of a mercury pocket that was excavated and just dumped directly into the river because it was excavated so close. And none of that has been remediated. You know, I worked in mental health in Lyon County for a long time. We have a huge incidence of way bigger than the rest of the state with mental health afflictions. And I have no doubt it's from the mass amount of mercury pollution that we have there. And there's no plans to do anything yet. You know, like the only thing right now that happens is if a housing development wants to build within a certain proximity, they have to do some testing to make sure that it's viable, and that's it. So no cleanup is happening. And when that incident happened, there was a huge amount of the river that just was dead. The fish were floating, there was nothing living, you know, from the pollution. And then we have Lake Lahontan that, you know, tons of people use for recreation. I don't let my kids swim there just because of the tangible evidence the first few times we went to the lake, and then like coming home and like not feeling really well, and then finding out you're not supposed to be eating the fish, you're not supposed to be eating the waterfowl if you hunt from there. And we're known for our public lands, and we should be able to hunt and fish and then consume those things. And right now it's poisonous, you know. And there's no plans to make it any better.
Hey everyone, it's Jen. I am back from Senator Dean Heller's office, and we requested a clear answer from Senator Dean Heller on where he stands with the environment for Nevada and how he stands for any more cuts happening to Nevada and the EPA. Our fire department strongly depends on the finances we get, and with 1.2 million acres burned in Nevada this year, I'm taking it very seriously, so I hope he is as well, along with our Superfund sites that we need to get cleaned up and cannot afford any more cuts to. So overall, I think it was a great meeting, and I'll let you know once I hear back from him on where he stands and what he's doing about it. Have a blessed day!